Let's take a look at some basic commands I might use as I create a drawing. I'll begin by looking at layers. Layers allow you to organize objects in your drawing. You can group similar objects so you can easily turn them off or on for displaying or printing. And you can lock layers to prevent unwanted changes. I'll expand the layers palette. This is where you create and manage your layers. I'm going to add a new layer called Objects to this drawing. Now I'll double-click to make it the current layer so the objects I draw are added to it automatically. I'll start drawing using the line command. Typically, when you start a command, you'll be prompted to input a value or specify an option. The input expected is displayed as a prompt in the command line and as a tooltip near the cursor if dynamic input is turned on. I'll turn dynamic input off for now. To indicate the first point of my line, I'll click in the drawing area. Now I'm prompted for the next point. I drag the cursor and click again. The line command continues to prompt for additional points until I end the command. To end the command, I can press Escape, Enter, or the space bar, or choose Enter from the command shortcut menu. To control drawing precision, I can choose from a variety of drafting aids. For example, the ortho mode button constrains me to vertical and horizontal lines as I draw. I'll turn ortho mode off again. Object snaps, also known as O-snaps, allow me to easily place new objects in relation to existing objects. I'll use the endpoint object snap to connect a new line to the endpoint of an existing line I've drawn. The auto snap marker makes it easy to know which object snap is being used. As you work on a design, you'll likely need to modify some objects. Before you can modify an object, you have to select it. To select an object, position your cursor over the object and click. I can add or remove objects in the current selection by holding the Shift key while I click the objects. I'll press Escape to clear the selection completely. Instead of selecting objects individually, I can select multiple objects at once with a selection window. I'll drag the cursor from left to right to select objects that are completely enclosed in the window. I'll drag from right to left to create a crossing selection, which selects all objects crossed by or enclosed in the window. Now let's look at some modify commands. I'll use the erase command to remove objects from my drawing. I'll select the object I want to remove and either click the erase tool or press delete. If I make a mistake, I can choose undo from the command shortcut menu. Let's say I want to move this fence support to the right. First, I zoom in. I can use the zoom command, or I can position my cursor and move two fingers apart on the trackpad to increase the magnification of the drawing. If you have a mouse, position the cursor and scroll the wheel, or slide one finger vertically on Magic Mouse. I'll pan the drawing by holding the space bar and dragging one finger on the trackpad or by moving the mouse. To move the fence support, I'll select it and click the Move tool. I'll use an endpoint object snap to move the support accurately from one fence board to another. Finally, I'll use the zoom command with the extents option to fit my design in the drawing area. In this video, we'll take a look at creating annotation on the front view of this drawing. Annotation can be used to communicate measurements, call out features, and provide information about your design. Text and dimensions are types of annotation. You control the appearance of annotation using styles. From the Format menu, I'll select Text Style. I'll select the user-defined text style, titles, from the styles list, which contains both user-defined and default text styles. Now when I create text objects, they'll be assigned the title text style. Now from the Format menu, I'll select Dimension Style and select Main as the current dimension style. After defining which styles to use for text and dimensions, I'm ready to annotate my drawing. In the Layers palette, I'll set the text layer current. The mtext command is used to create multi-line text. Mtext prompts you to specify two points in the drawing to determine the width of the multi-line text object. I can use the text editor visor to specify text formatting, or accept the default formatting and start typing in the in-place editor. I'll click Save after I finish adding my text. I'll return to the Layers palette and set the dimension layer current. You can create different types of dimensions such as linear, radial, or angular. One way to dimension objects is to select a dimension command, press Enter, and select the object you want to dimension. This is an efficient way to dimension lines or polyline segments. If I want more control over which points are used to create the dimension, I can use object snaps to specify start and end points in the drawing. To dimension this arc, I'll select radius. Next, I'll select the arc and click here to place the dimension. Adding text and dimensions to your drawing finalizes your design.